Hello everyone, my name is Fazal. You are watching MFA Civil Engineering. Basically, we are going to learn a various technical terms used in the stone masonry one by one. The exterior of a wall exposed to the weather is called face, and the material used in the face of a wall is called as a facing. The inner surface of a wall which is not exposed to the weather is called as a back, and the material used in the back of the wall is called as a backing. The interportion of a wall between the facing and the backing is called as a hurting. In a stone masonry, some stone in one piece or in a two piece at a regular interval are placed right across the wall. Such stone are termed as the throat stone or a bond stone. This stone increases the bonding capacity between the facing and the backing. The junction of a two or more stone in a wall construction is called as a joint, and the horizontal layer of a stone in a wall is called as a course. The stone which lies with its longest side parallel to the face of the work is called as a stretcher, and the stone which lies with its longest side perpendicular to the face of the work is called as a header. The external corner or a angle of a wall surface are called as a quin, and the stone forming the quin are known as a quin stone. The block of a stone used at a corner of a two wall meeting at a 90 degree is called as a quin header. The projecting course at a ground floor level is known as a plinth. The plinth course protects the interior of a building from the rainwater and the frost. The topmost layer or the course of a plinth masonry is called as a plinth course. The bottom surface of a door or window opening is known as a sill, and the sill stone are dressed so that they prevent the entry of a water to the interior of the building. The projecting stone, which is usually provided to serve as a support of a roof tile, beam, and the weather shed, is called as a corbel. The course of a stone provided at the top of the wall is called as the cornice. It is generally molded and give a ornamental treatment. It is weather and throat to dispose of rainwater. The course of a stone provided immediately below a cornice is called as a frieze. This may be a flush with wall or may be a molded. The course of a stone masonry provided immediately above the cornice to check the tendency of a cornice to overturn is called as a blocking course. The special course protective covering which is placed on the top of the wall to exclude the water from the wall below is called as the coping. Coping are provided to the wall such as the boundary wall and the parapet wall. The top surface of a coping, that is a plane surface inclined to the horizontal to throw off the rainwater, is called as the weathering. The groove made on the under surface of a coping or a sill so as to keep off seepage water from the surface of a wall is called as the throating. The horizontal course provided at a suitable level between the plinth and the cornice is termed as the string course. The horizontal course provided to strengthen the wall of an irregular small stone is called as the lacing course. The stone chips used for the packing up and the filling the void of a stone masonry are called as a spalls. The arrangement of a stone to overlap each other in a such manner that no continuous vertical joint occur either on the face or inside the wall is called as the bond.